I love you,
Allah. Get so tied up in this world that they forget that their real concern and worry and anxiety should be in the hereafter. What Islam teaches us is this: change your worry and grief from the matters of this world to the matters of the hereafter. Make your primary worry that keeps you up at night, what is going to happen to me when I die? And what this will do is it will instantly relieve your worries in this world, because they will seem so insignificant compared to the worry over what will happen to you when you die, that they become manageable. The big monster actually was just a really little small one. It's just a shadow that made it look really big. And there's a lovely hadith in this, and that is that the Prophet, peace be upon him, said, whoever makes their concerns, their worries, their grief, their depression, their sadness over a single thing, the concern of what will happen to them in the hereafter, then Allah says, Allah will take care of your world and your hereafter. And Allah will make your world easy, this life easy for you, and Allah will make your hereafter easy for you. And whoever allows their worry and grief to be spread out among the matters of this worldly life, Allah does not care in which of its valleys they die. Meaning Allah does not care whether it is their wealth that kills them, or their love for status that will kill them, or their children, or their health, or their worries over job security. Allah does not care which one of them destroys them, whichever valley they die in. But the one whom Allah takes care of is the one who transfers his concerns to the concerns of the hereafter, who makes their concern their primary thing that is keeping them awake and worrying them, not my job security and my money and my children and my whatever and my degree and whatever I'm doing, what's going to happen, what has happened, what have I done, what will I do, what about this relationship, and instead dumps all of that and starts to worry about what will happen to me when I die. And this, honestly, the whole of the world just becomes insignificant. And I give you an example of that. The Pharaoh who fought against Moses. Some of the people became Muslim, and Pharaoh got them, and he said, I'm going to nail you to date palm trees. I'm going to crucify you on a date palm tree. And you know what they said to him? Do whatever you want, because whatever you're going to do to me, it's only in this world. But as for what God has promised me in the hereafter, that is the true life. That is the life that I'm worried about. So do whatever you want. Why is it that the worry over the hereafter is so much greater, and yet we manage it much better as human beings? Because ultimately in the hereafter, what will happen to us is down to the mercy of Almighty God. And in this world, we're worrying about the mercy of the guy or the girl sat next to you. And the reality is that people are not very merciful to one another. If you're worrying about what the person you've got a debt to, or your professor, or your parents are going to say, then this is a worry, because you have no guarantee that they will treat you fairly or mercifully in any way. As for the hereafter, you have a cast iron guarantee that you will be treated fairly and mercifully.